Khilafat is the system of spiritual leadership that was established in the early period of Islam after the demise of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and was reinstated in 1908 after the demise of Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, peace be upon him, the founder of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Association. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and great honor to introduce to you His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, the fifth successor of the Promised Messiah, peace be upon him, and the head of the worldwide Ahmadiyya Muslim Association. Dear Hazur.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. All the honorable guests, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Peace and blessing of Allah be upon you all. First of all, I would like to thank all our respected guests who have come here on the auspicious occasion of the inauguration of this mosque. By doing so, you have all shown your friendship, illustrated great courage, and given proof of your care for humanity. What the world requires most of all is tolerance. As the world draws closer and the global village begins to emerge, there is a need to replace hatred and malice with love, affection, and forbearance. One should be sensitive to the feelings of others, and there should be respect and reverence for each other's faith. Attention needs to be drawn towards discharging the rights of each other. If these qualities do not emerge, then despite the world coming together, it will be further divided, and its drawing closer will prove to be a curse rather than being a source of pride. Therefore, it is very praiseworthy that you have respected our feelings by participating today. These are the avenues that will lead to love, kindness, and tolerance, and take us all the way up to the pinnacle of humanity. My prayer is that this function today offers a means of consolidating love, affection, and tolerance, and proves to be a milestone for the development of these qualities. As for how far we understand this concept and adhere to these principles, permit me please to clarify. The founder of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, has taught us that there were two purposes of his coming. One was to bring man closer to God, the Creator, and the other was to draw the attention of mankind towards discharging the rights of God's creation. He said that discharging the rights of others selflessly was a very difficult task. However, he further stated that after joining his community, it is obligatory upon Ahmadis to fulfill these duties. Our slogan, love for all, hatred for none, is based on this teaching, namely that if malice and hatred are present, then due rights cannot be upheld. So while this mosque, which by the way is called Baitul Afiyat, as have been mentioned earlier, that is a house of peace, tranquility and safety, draws our attention towards the worship of Allah, it also continues to impress upon us the obligation to serve and safeguard the rights of His creation. As a result of observing these rights, love, affection, and peace will further develop. We therefore try to live within these parameters, whose outer boundaries are guarded against those who usurp the rights of others and spread hatred. This discipline is supervised by the Khalifa of the time. Whosoever tries to exceed these limits causes himself harm. We claim that everything we do is for the sake of God Almighty. And God Almighty is very kind to His creation. The majority of the world does not fulfill the rights of its Creator. But even so, God Almighty does not seek revenge. This does not mean that God does not exist. It is, as it is said by some people of some school of thoughts. Nor does it lead to the question, which is that if someone does not exist, how can he take revenge? Allah says in the Holy Quran that if He starts punishing people, immediately they go astray, then not only will man, but all living creatures in the universe will be eliminated. As the following verse throws more light on it, Quran says, "And if Allah were to punish men for their wrongdoing, He would not leave thereon a living creature, but He gives them respite till an appointed term." Chapter 16, verse 62. So we believe in that God who does not punish the moment a wrong is committed. Were He to punish instantly, He could easily terminate or withdraw the resources upon which we are dependent. Upon reflection, we will realize that our lives and what we eat are dependent upon a wide array of things, ranging from small bacteria to livestock, even the total life on the earth.